everybody. Claire A. Randall at wakingthemonkey.blogspot.co.uk. Right, well, I'm just wanting to get online and register my support and approval for what President Donald Trump has done with his just recently tweeted comment that no longer will transgenders, as is the word, you know, I don't like the word transgender, but it's the common word in use, will not be allowed in the US military henceforth, and because of the cost and the potential disruption. And, right, okay, so I have done several interviews recently about the subject of transsexuality and what is now called transgenderism, but I dislike the term for reasons I've explained elsewhere, I think. I have done these interviews on trans, and I've come out as trans myself. I went through the process some 30 years ago, and I completely agree with Donald Trump. I can't imagine how anybody could go through transsexual or transgender reassignment and carry on military duties at the same time. I mean, it's utterly absurd. It's like, you know, this took like about 4 years out of my life in the mid-80s. You know, it is also quite, what you might call, well, you know, the medical procedures, you know, and, you know, people aren't going to be as strong afterwards, basically. You know, military service is a full-time commitment, and if you've got something else as major as trans reassignment going on, then it's like, what on earth are you doing in the military? This is like something that is just so major that everything else has to take a kind of, you know, second, third and fourth place behind it. It's just utterly ludicrous. So obviously, there have already been, you know, many accusations of this is bigotry. Oh yeah, Trump is bigoted. Trump is prejudiced against trans people and gay people. And yet, I know that Trump is principally concerned with practicalities. He is a pragmatist, and I don't think he has a prejudice bone in his body, because I think that he's a businessman. He's interested in what works, what is most efficient, and what runs best. And a US military with people changing gender and having sex reassignment, it's just like, yeah, you know, what's that about going on in the military? I absolutely reject, I do not accept that Trump is prejudiced or he's bigoted about this, because I remember about 18 months ago now, the beginning of last year, there was the appalling Orlando massacre, the gay nightclub shooting by that Islamic terrorist. And I remember Trump was down there like a shot. And he, I remember very vividly the speech he gave, saying that, and he used the term LGBTQ. I think he probably thought, what on earth's going on here? But, you know, my press secretary has told me this is the term to use. But, you know, he got up there and he said it, and he said that LGBTQ people, you know, will be protected and they will be safe in his America if he got elected, which fortunately he was. Because LGBT and, you know, other similar kind of minority people are obviously seriously at risk from, you know, the true bigots who are, you know, under Islamic belief themselves, who think that they have the right to go killing and murdering gay people or LGBT people, you know. So I completely reject that. And really what this was all about was because Obama put this, Obama, this is one of his kind of dog days orders that he put in shortly before he became the lame duck president after the election. Because back in October of a year ago, Obama introduced this new status whereby in the American military, you know, transgender people, as they're called in America, would be taken in, you know, and even if they're having their treatment there at the time, and you know, even if they have the treatment under the American military. So this is complete political correctness and virtue signaling from the fortunately now ex-president Obama. It's just it's completely inappropriate, and it's quite obvious that he was doing this to further the cultural Marxist agenda of political correctness and deconstructing our society away from conventional models. And I have to say quite firmly that I may be transsexual, but I do believe strongly in the conventional, traditional models of male and female. And you may say, well, how can that be? Well, I also believe that there are anomalies, and that, you know, nature you know, makes errors sometimes. You know, we see how, you know, people are sometimes born you know, intersex, or with you know, a club foot, or some kind of you know, deformity or something. And transsexualism and is just a condition like that. You know, I'm certainly in favour of people, you know, getting help for it if they, you know, feel strongly about it, as I did. But I do believe that there should be forms of definition about this, is what I'm trying to say, that we shouldn't be just, I mean, I'm kind of wandering a little bit into what's happening in this country, because, of course, we've got another attempt at a Gender Declaration Act, which is being brought forward by this Conservative government, which is, it was not in the manifesto, and I hoped that it had died with the general election, because the Lady Maria Miller, who put it forward, obviously, that died before that, you know, died when the election happened. But there's a new one now, and they want to bring in this gender declaration. And now the whole thing is the same thing with Obama and what we've got going here. It's all cultural Marxist ploys to break down the basis of our society, of which is the family, and the family is made up of men and women. And now we have this absurd thing. I think in Canada there's some new law being brought in to recognise, you know, 57 varieties of gender or something. And I've heard Jordan Peterson talking about a little bit about this, and how people will be you know, prosecuted for, quote, misgendering people. You know, and if somebody, you know, doesn't call me she, they might get a bit of mouth from me, but I don't think that it's something that I should have the right to take them to court over and have them fined thousands of dollars, like, you know, they're trying to do. It's utterly absurd. It's just political correctness and cultural Marxism. It's, you know, the culture of critique. Everything has to be criticised. Everything has to be broken down. Everything has to be deconstructed. But, and this is what, this is, you know, Obama put his, you know, transgender in the army, in the military forces, together, it was quite obvious it was part of his agenda. He was like a kind of scorched earth kind of policy that he left behind him in case, you know, Trump got in, thank goodness. And also preparing the ground for if Hillary got in, obviously she would have pushed these things further. And it's just completely inappropriate, as I've heard people say already, you know. The military is not a place for social issues. It's a place for people to function effectively. So I'm just very, very pleased that President Trump has pushed this back, and I'm hoping that it will have some kind of knock-on effect in this country, because, you know, you might think this is very strange for someone who, you know, admits to being transsexual, but I'm just terrified at what they're doing with this at the moment. I don't recognise the current wave of media promotion of transgenderism is something I do not recognise as having anything to do with my own experience. Really, absolutely nothing. I did it because I really felt I had to. And in the 1980s, you know, there was medical treatment available, but you had to really qualify for it. I mean, you had to go through really extensive triage assessment, you know, psychiatrists assessing that you weren't mentally unstable, you know. And I know some people would say, well, it's a definition of being mentally unstable, but I don't agree with that. If you have some kind of, you know, intersexual condition, then, you know, I don't see anything wrong in self-determination as sorting it out. But what I do very much object to, and which I see this Obama thing being a part of, with this current new gender declaration law that they're trying to bring through in this country, and also this insane attempt in Canada, I should say, to certainly wouldn't have it in China, to actually, you know, Jordan Peterson, I've seen, he has commented that it actually could, you know, contradict the Canadian Constitution and free speech, you know, to say that, you know, people who misgender trans people can be prosecuted and put in prison for just speaking what they believe. Well, you know, if people don't pass very well as women, then, you know, you can't stop people having perceptions. You know, that's why I think it's really important that people should, if people are determined to go through trans reassignment, then they should do it seriously. They should make a serious attempt to be a convincing person in the gender you desire. You know, Obama's other thing, of course, on transgender toilets. I mean, he was literally, you know, legislating that anybody can go into a woman's toilet. A man with a beard, you know, and a beer gut could go into a woman's toilet. And as I think there were some episodes, I don't know whether they had beards and beer guts, but there was an episode of a man going into a woman's toilet, taking off his clothes and saying, I identify as a woman. You know, it had no diagnosis, no assessment, no treatment, no attempt to transition, nothing. Nothing. And yet, the law, in all these different places, people are trying to make it such that you just say, well, I'm a woman, you know, or I'm a man, or whatever, you know, and I don't have to produce any evidence. I don't have to do anything. I don't have to behave in a different way, I don't have to look in a different way, because it's all just deconstructed anyway, isn't it? You know, there's no difference between men and women. So, you know, if there's no difference between men and women, why does it start in the first place? It's just it's an attempt to destroy the natural layout of things as the nature nature intends it. And yeah, you have a few anomalies, people like me, you know, but I don't want to change the basic structure of gender in society. I'm all in favour of there being men and women and women and women getting married and being parents and being mothers and fathers. And these words, I believe in Canada, the words mother and father, and that's part of this bill they want to outlaw. The words mother and father, boy and girl, you know, no, child, you know, you're not allowed to call someone a boy or a girl because it's, you know, it's prescriptive or something. So, you know, I think that it's really good that we're having some pushback on this issue from Trump. And I thought it was important to get a quick video out about this because we have this issue going on in this country where the Conservatives have, you know, ludicrously decided that they want to have a Gender Declaration Act, making the what the Labour did in 2004 look almost traditional and conservative, you know. So we really need to be, you know, kicking up a stink about this, and because I don't think my sense of where the world is at about the trans issue is that people don't mind trans people if they fit in, if they pass, if they look all right, if they behave appropriately. I remember even as, you know, 20 or 30 years ago, people saying, oh, well, yeah, you know, if you can fit in and you know, be socially acceptable, then, you know, and no, if it's not obvious to people, then they're, you know, not. I have a little debate here with a chap called Pale Hominid, who thinks, he's quite a nice chap. I've enjoyed some of his conversations with Millennial Woes, but he thinks that we shouldn't exist, or if we are going to exist, that we should to completely repress ourselves, and I don't find this an acceptable solution. However, what I do find an acceptable solution is that trans people should make an effort to fit in, and then society will respect them. I mean, that seems like an equal bargain to me. But this endless political agenda which people like Obama and Trudeau seem to have is that everybody has to fit their deconstruction agenda. And I would point out here that building societies and rights around a minority, which I've mentioned previously, is 0.2% of the population. 0.2%. So that means that 99.8% of the population are what the SJWs would call cisgendered. In other words, are gender normative, traditional gender normative. And that is way above the statistical correlation level of, you know, standard deviations and stuff. In other words, the 99.8% is normal, and the 0.2% are anomalies. And, you know, I'm prepared to admit that I'm an anomaly, but I do my best to be acceptable and fit into society, and I'm a pillar of the community locally. To Mr. Jason Horsley, who recently called me dysfunctional and extreme, I would point out that I am a pillar of the local community. But I never tried to force myself onto situations like the military. Just coming back to that, to wind it up, I would say, yes, I'm very, very pleased that Trump has taken a most simple, reasonable and pragmatic step in this. I know that the SJWs and the cultural Marxists were all, you know, beat up on him and scold him no end for him having, you know, the temerity to put practicalities and function before the feelings of people, you know. I felt utterly ludicrous. Obama is quite obviously, he was trying to salt the earth, you know, he was trying to leave a scorched earth behind him. Utterly ludicrous. And I fully support Trump. He's restoring some normality into it. People with long-term medical conditions should not be signing up for military service. Okay, righto. Got some links below to my blogs and stuff. I hope you'll maybe check them out. Righto. Thanks a lot, everybody. Thanks for watching. Bye.